Moving on to Motion 80, that's been proposed by Mary Collins and seconded by Angela Timlin, candidate in the local elections in Dunleary.
My name is Mary Collins, and I'm a member of the Jack Fitzgerald Fund, Dunleary. I have cerebral palsy, and I've been confined to a wheelchair since birth. The proposal before you is that Ireland is one of the few countries in the EU that does not have a human rights commissioner for people with disabilities. This is vital to ensure that proper resourcing is maintained. I have been living on my own since August 2000. With the help of three personal assistants who help me in every aspect of my life. Without them, I would be in an institution and feel like a prisoner with no dignity and freedom. One of my first experiences of institutionalization was being put to bed at 4 p.m. not because I wanted to go, but because I was forced to go, probably because of staffing levels. There are a number of situations I can recall of a similar nature. I was among the first 30 people get a PA service in Ireland so that I could go to Trinity College. I have since got a master's degree and graduated with a master's degree in February 2009. Now, most of the PA services are administered through the Irish Wheelchair Association and other service providers. Through having PAs, I have been able to do voluntary and community work. And therefore, the personal assistants have enabled me to live independently and keep my dignity. The most recent external review of assisted living services done for the IWA states 7,000 people, 7,000 possible service users for PAs in Ireland, and have yet to be assessed, and 600 are on the waiting list. As the Supreme Court Justice Ruth Bader Ginsburg stated in an equality case in Tennessee, right. And that sometimes you have to treat citizens differently to give them equal dignity. In order for all citizens to treat all citizens differently with equal dignity. Sometimes have to treat citizens, some citizens, differently to attain equal dignity. I fear my PA hours will be cut so drastically. Under the Disability Act 2005, which is very draconian in its measures, throughout the boom years, the government neglected to ring fence funding for people with disabilities. Now that the economic downturn has happened, the government is looking for cutting costs by taking vital services away from people with disabilities. The Disability Act 2005 is draconian in nature by insisting that people with disabilities must apply to their local agency to keep the services they already have, let alone apply for any extra services needed. I got extra hours in 2007 from the HSC because at that time I had to spend 6 hours on a Sunday and be collected by accessible community transport Southside to visit my elderly parents, and this goes against health and safety because their health cannot cater for my needs adequately. Because of having personal assistance, people with significant disabilities in Ireland have been employed and are employable. Thank you for listening to me.